Vice President Yemi Osinbajo has declared his readiness to waive his constitutional immunity to enable the most robust adjudication of several business allegations, insinuations and falsehood against his person and office. Professor Osinbajo made this declaration in a tweet he personally authored yesterday's afternoon. Osinbajo tweeted, "In the past few days, a spate of reckless and malicious falsehoods have been peddled in the media against him by a group of malicious individuals. The defamatory and misleading assertions invected by this clique had mostly been making the social media rounds anonymously," he said. The vice president has instructed the commencement of legal action against two individuals, one Timi Frank and another Catch Ononuju, who have put their names to these odious falsehoods. Osinbajo vowed to waive his constitutional immunity to enable the most robust adjudication of these false claims of libel and malicious falsehood. Now, earlier, Plus TV Africa spoke with legal practitioner Christian Wogu on this matter.
Interesting. I mean, it's going to help the Nigerian legal system to get more reports. Because, and then, of course, the polity, everything about this is exciting. What I'm not sure is whether the vice president can waive his immunity, for starters. But it's good to hear that can happen. There's always a starting point so that when he waives his, we're probably going to ask a lot of governors and deputy governors to start waiving their immunities, because there's a whole lot that this immunity, if he is saying, look, I want to do that, that's his will, and somehow the courts will make pronouncements, and that's why it may be necessary for him to actually appear in court, for starters, so that we can get judicial pronouncements on some of these things. Because certain things begin to happen, and the real revolution starts. That is the revolution that gives value, bloodless and without, because there is so much to, now there's an allegation that such an amount of money was spent during elections. Now, my question is the vice president saying such an amount of money was not spent? Is he saying more than that was spent? Is he saying that no money was spent at all? Is he saying, so there are so much about this to be looked into. And if he wants to go through the judicial option, I think the vice president is welcome, because somebody has to make a petition to the EFCC. And apparently, it will have to be this Timi Frank that will petition the EFCC that about all of this. Again, this Timi Frank, where is he coming from? Where is he getting all his facts and figures from? So essentially, what I'm thinking is happening here is that the space for further conversation is being opened or reopened. And I think that the vice president should take it in good faith. You know, let him, it has been brought to the public domain, let him first and foremost, before even we start the court option, go back to the public domain now that he's tweeting, and let us hear his version. But because I know that this team, yes, I understand he has had some stint with APC and maybe still does. So it's actually love gone sour that's happening here. And we mustn't lose sight of all of this. I don't think he should be bullish. I don't think that the vice president should be bullish in approaching this. He should just let the conversation flow. I think that already his integrity hasn't been very tainted or impugned. Somebody wants to take a headlong approach to it and say, look, Vice President, you're on the hot seat right now. We are talking about politics here. This is power. I mean, politics is about power play, different angles of power play. So if it's what's happening now, one thing eventually happens. Somebody goes down ultimately in power play. And it doesn't necessarily have to be the Vice President. It's just like when two lions, one of them wants to take over a pride, one of the lions will have to go down. So there is just power play that's happening. Sometimes the ultimate beneficiary of all of this is you and I. Look, the vice president is a Nigerian foremost. Now, essentially, he is the vice president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. So somebody has made an allegation against him. And he says he's written, so his legal process is in place. He's written through his lawyers and said, look, we are taking you to court if you don't do A, B, C, D. And the other guy says, fine.
I'm not retracting.
I'm ready to meet you in court.